Credit scoring has much to offer to microfinance institutions and smaller banks. It is a simple and powerful tool in reducing operational costs and loan losses. Moreover, it speeds up the loan request evaluation process, reducing costs and improving customer satisfaction. Who would not be interested? In this series of videos, we will discuss four simple credit scoring techniques. Expert approach. Bayesian scoring. Logistic regression. And the Altman Z score. Our goal is to demystify the mathematics and logic behind these models. We will explain in plain terms the underlying principles. Using simple Excel models, we show how to use these techniques in practice. Even smaller institutions without sophisticated IT systems can put in place these scoring techniques. We will kick off with the simplest technique, expert scoring. The expert scoring technique is nothing more than a systematic implementation of the credit agent's common wisdom. Every bank or IMF has solid expertise and experience in evaluating a loan requests. All the expert scoring technique does is capturing this internal knowledge and turn this expertise in score. Financial institutions continuously make decisions on new loan requests. In the end, this boils down to a binary outcome. Either we accept or reject the request. The expert approach seeks to structure the process to get to this yes or no answer. A series of questions and checks is made. The answers are categorized and limited. This means we must pick an answer from a list as if it were a fast food restaurant menu. Each answer chosen produces a score. The point total for all questions is the score. We can refine our model further by assigning a weight to the questions. Maybe we judge that certain questions are more important than other questions. The total score is the weighted sum of points. But let us look at an Excel example. We will make a simple loan demand evaluation form with four questions. For each question, we have four options for the answers. We start with a question about the entrepreneur's business experience. We create a list of four possible answers. 1. New business, 2. Less than a year, 3. Between 1 and 5 years, and 4. More than 5 years. Excel has a neat option under the Data tab that is called Data Validation. We choose the option list, which creates a pull-down menu. We select the four possible answers. We do the same thing for question 2 for the sector. Again, we create a pull-down menu with the list. 1. Agriculture, 2. Services, 3. Fishing, and 4. Crafts. We complete the questionnaire. Now we are going to assign points to each of the answers. Keep in mind that this is a bogus questionnaire and that the scores we assign here are just for demo purposes. Let us look at the first question on business experience. The scores we assign range from 1 to 5, with 5 as the best score. So, a new business gets just 1 point, while an entrepreneur that has been in business for more than 5 years receives 5 points. We put these points right behind each of the answer options. Now we can show the score for each question depending on the answer given. We use the Excel vertical lookup function to do this. We refer in the first argument to the answer given. The second argument is the two-column table with the possible answers and the corresponding scores. The third argument is 2, since we want Excel to pick the corresponding score which is in the second column of our table. We complete the function with false to say that we want a precise match. We see that Excel posts the correct score for each question depending on the answer given. The last thing to do is to assign a weight to each of the questions. We do this in column F since there are four questions, we could assign an equal weight of 25% to each of them. But we think question 1 is more important. We assign a weight of 40% to 1, 30% to question 2 and just 15% to questions 3 and 4. Now everything is in place to calculate the client score. The score is the sum of the weighted scores for the four questions. We can calculate this with the Excel sumproduct function. This function allows us to multiply the scores with the weights in on one shot. We only must define the two arrays. And, voila, we are done. How to interpret the score. In our example, a higher score means higher creditworthiness. The way we configured our scoring model, the lowest score possible is 1.3 and the best 5.0. As a financial institution, we could say, everyone with a score of 4.0 or higher, we accept. Below 4.0 is a reject. We could make things a bit more sophisticated. 4 and higher we accept. Below 3 we reject. The gray area between 4 and 5 we forward to our credit committee. We see that the score can function as a gatekeeper in the workflow. The score determines whether to send a file to the credit committee. Often people wonder whether the score determines in the end who will get a loan. This all depends on how the bank or IMF would like to use the score. You could look at it as just an advice or indicator next to other indicators. The other end of the spectrum is that indeed the loan evaluation is automated using the scoring. The bank makes this decision. For small loans that are granted in large volumes, automation makes sense. The costs of human evaluation weigh heavily on small loans. There is also a third blended approach possible. A combination of a score and human evaluation. For example, we could depend on the judgment of the business relationship officer next to the score. Say, we get the green light from this bank officer and the score traffic light is also green. In that case, we could go ahead and grant the loan. If both lights are red, then it would be a rejection. If one light is red and the other green, we would have a stalemate. These cases are referred to the credit committee to decide. The advantage is that we combine human evaluation with scoring. Moreover, we freed the credit committee from discussing every loan request. With our filtering in place, the committee can focus on the more difficult dossiers that require more time. The majority, however, are clear green or red lights and can be processed without much ado. We say that our scoring approach saves time and costs and allows us to focus on the important stuff. To wrap things up, these are the advantages of the expert scoring approach. Systematic processing of information and evaluation elements regarding loan request. Captures the financial institution's expertise and experience. Offers a template credit officers can follow. Has a clear numeric outcome that is helpful in decision making. Can be combined with other evaluation approaches and integrated in the workflow. Thanks for watching. Make sure to watch our other videos on Bayesian scoring, logistic regression, and the Altman Z score.